So what do you get in the pack? Well, you get 16 signs for the frames, which you cut this out on the pips, and basically that's the front part of the sign, and that's the legs that will fit in the back. And then you have this choice of these signs here, from your rectangle ones to your triangle and the square ones with the round signs on. Now on the back you get the printed back part of the signs that you cut out. So the first thing is to cut out your triangle and the back bit, and it's held open by one pip for the triangle there and one pip there. So using a sharp craft knife, and you should be very careful. Cut through that and through that, and this should pop out. Don't be tempted to twist them, as it'll bend, but there you go. So that's your two bits. You may just want to clean up the pip that you've cut. The next job then is to paint these. I use the Woodland Scenics Steel Rail Track Taddy paint pen. So it's a case of going across and painting both sides. And as you can see here, here's two that we've done earlier. So it's now a case of gluing these together. So what we do now is we slide the legs into the two recesses on the triangle frame. And it's the top part of the H, so you imagine like, was it rugby goalposts, that goes down at the bottom there. So now what we'll do is we'll add a drop of glue, and we're using the Rokit car glue by Deluxe Materials. So if we just put a tiny drop on there and there, and we'll leave that to set a minute. It's then a case of cutting out the sign you want. So I've cut out this rose skid sign. Now I have a thought on this, is that if you wanted to make more use of this pack of signs, instead of gluing these on, you could use the Deluxe Materials tacky wax and just put a little smidgen of wax on there, and then just put the sign there. So when you want to change the sign, it's just a case of peeling the sign off and putting one of the signs on. Now that the glue has dried a bit, we'll just put a little bit more around the frame for the sign to go on. So it's only a tiny amount you really want, so we'll just put some in each corner. We'll put a little bit too much on there. And then it's just a case of now getting sign and sticking that on. I'm going to square it up. And there you can see the completed sign. So it's a quick, easy kit that it only takes basically about a minute or so to do.